The top five real estate trends for 2020.
Yeah, marketing ideas there.
Yeah.
And you want to go through those? Welcome to the Weekender, episode 25. I'm Brandon Roberts here with your co-host, Jesse Lucero.
How you doing, guys?
Good. Another fantastic week at Signature.
Absolutely.
Started off Monday with the Masterminds. Mm-hmm. I know Kelly did hers up there, and she talked about branding.
Branding and tactics.
Tactics.
Yeah, it was good.
Yeah, and Tyson and Tamara did theirs. They gave a special gift to the participants. They created a prospecting workbook that they shared with them that they're going to be working out of all this week. All this month, mm-hmm. actually, so it's pretty cool. Tuesday was a fabulous sales meeting. I thought it was really, really good to see the broker panel up there.
We'll get to know your brokers at a different level.
It was comical, informative, and mm-hmm. It made me really proud and excited for 2020, knowing that those guys are at the forefront of the offices.
Leadership.
Yeah, so we had Chris Bishop, our newest addition, mm-hmm. Janet Carpenter, and Kelly Bishop sat on the panel, and then our very own Vonna Bala moderated it. So there was great questions. I thought that was neat. And if you missed that, again, it's in the Facebook group. It went up on Tuesday night, and you can find it under the Units tab.
Or you should have gotten it in your newsletter.
Yeah.
So check your email.
You can always click on the link in your newsletter, too.
Yeah.
Which, I mean, that newsletter has been fabulous since mm-hmm. you've redesigned it. It's kind of a one-stop to get everything, because you can go to the Facebook page to get things. You can go to our YouTube page. You can go all kinds of places. But what Jesse and Beta have done is they put that together in the newsletter along with the content, a lot of content that Janet writes.
So this week we put a education section. So when they click on that, it'll take them to the units in our Facebook group.
So there you go. Really cool. So I think that's fabulous, and it's like I said, there's no excuse for you not to be able to get the information that's there.
Mm-hmm.
We also, next week, we've got Erin Patrick's doing her Real Estate Academy, and I'll be in the Southwest office, and that starts Monday. So if you're interested in that, see her on that and get signed up. And this last week, you did Java with Jesse,
and we covered the digital aspect of branding.
Yeah.
Really cool. We talked about which websites are working best in regards to saving your time as you design your branding look online. So if you attended Java with Jesse, you should be getting an email today that shows the rest of the other websites that I use to be able to come up with like great branding for flyers, for social media images, cool stuff like that.
Yeah, see, and that's neat. I mean, with technology and the internet, things are so simple. I mean, and when I first started selling real estate, I mean, we had to have somebody do a graphic design on a flyer, or you had to have these templates for that.
Now it would take days, right?
Yeah, and now you can just go to a website and design it in minutes and print it or send it to a printer, and it's just, it makes it so easy. There's really no excuse.
So I use a website called Lucid Press, and what I like about it, oh man, there you go again. What I love about it is that you could save your templates and then you just come back and you drag and drop. It's very similar to Canva. We also use Canva, but what I liked about Lucid Press is it just saves you time. You're here to sell.
That's right.
Yeah.
But we're in the business of marketing. You know, we market properties, we got to market ourselves, so it pays to really have a good image out there.
Yeah.
And I know you shared with me an article. What was that article?
What is the top five real estate trends for 2020?
Yeah, marketing ideas there.
Yeah.
And you want to go through those?
Yeah, so they talked about, I'm just going to cover the bullet points and then we'll just talk about what you think. So one of the things they offered is as advice is to create multiple landing pages as part of your real estate strategy for 2020. What do you think of that?
So I think it's a good idea. So a landing page is, when you run an ad or you do any marketing, mm-hmm. it's a place where they're going to go to. And if you let's say you have a listing on XYZ Street and you want to drive traffic to your website or drive traffic to that, and you run an ad on that property, if they come to the front of your website, you've lost them. right?
Yeah.
Because when they click on that link, they want to go to the page that has the information that they're interested in.
Yeah, keep them in one thought, right?
Right.
I want this property. That's
and then a landing page can be is designed really to get them there and then to convert them into a lead, get them to sign up for something or to get more information or something, right?
Yeah.
So, and you can do this through your Simplelist
website
on an upgrade for the listing websites. Those are basically listing landing pages that give all the information that really stand out. And it's simple. It's drag and drop and just fill in the blank.
And if you talk to the Simplelist team, what I like about the websites is that you have the ability to retarget. I'm all about retargeting. If somebody sees this property, the next time they go online, they're going to see the next ad, which could possibly be a video testimonial, or it could be another property.
Right. You know, something in the past, too, one of the ways we generate leads was through free reports, like top 10 things you need to know before you sell your home, stuff like that. And we'd run ads in the newspaper and stuff.
Okay.
But think about this. If you go to a website like leadpages.com and you create a landing page to get a free report and you run those kinds of things, that will cause consumers to raise their hand.
Yeah.
So think outside the box. You don't just need a landing page for property. You can do them for other things to get people to show their interest. Mm-hmm. And if you need those free reports, contact me because I've got a whole bunch of them.
I need those free reports.
You need them?
Yeah.
The other thing is, you know how you really get them?
How's that?
Just go to Google.
Oh, they're all there?
Yeah, if you just Google whatever report you want, it'll be there.
Really?
But I do. I have a whole booklet of them, so I'd be happy to share that with you guys. But just IM me or send me a message, and I'll get that out to you.
Uh-huh.
But I'll get you a copy, too.
All right.
So.
All right, so the next one is leverage the power of social media. And some of the ways you could use social media to create more engagement for you is simply ask questions on it.
Yeah.
That's what they mentioned. Run some polls. Do images that engage a like or a post or some type of comment. What do you think of that?
So I like that. And I know Shelly, in about three or four sales meetings back, gave kind of a social media plan.
True.
And one of them was to ask questions and put that. And if you actually follow her and watch, she's doing that consistently. Mm-hmm. So it might be a question to ask her what kind of results she's getting. But if you ask questions that are designed to identify people as a potential buyer or seller, and they're answering these, there's a lead list for you to call.
That's true. And you know, leads are not always phone number and address. It could just be a simple email address for now, because that's the first stage of marketing, is to gain their interest. And
right.
then the next stage could be through retargeting.
Right.
If you want this free report, you got to give your email, your phone number.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think social media, there's a big place for it, but I think done wrong, it can be a big time suck.
Absolutely.
And I think most people are doing it wrong, just posting stuff. I think you really need to put together a strategy and what your purpose is for each post and how you're marketing the stuff to generate the business or the leads that you want.
So our last Java with Jesse, we talked about planning.
Uh-huh.
Like, for example, I plan to have, I don't know, 100 open houses this year. You need to decide today, what is it that I'm going to do every time I have an open house? And it could be, I'm going to make a post and ask a question. It could be,
there you go.
I'm going to put a post of the kitchen and ask, how would you decorate, how would you change this around?
Right.
You know, stuff like
great.
That. Yeah.
What do you think of the colors? Anything.
There you go. Yeah.
A poll, different things like that.
Mm-hmm.
The different types of houses you like,
yeah.
two-story, one-story, gated community, whatever. You can do all kinds of stuff to get engagement, right?
So, but if you plan ahead, you'll always know what's on your checklist to do every single time, because it's all about consistency.
To create an open house process.
There you go.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So the next bullet point here was know where real estate agents are posting their listings. So that's a big trend. I haven't posted in individual websites, but what do you recommend?
So this is interesting too, because there was a time when it was very beneficial to post your listings in Craigslist.
Yeah.
And so a lot of people, that was their strategy. They'd post them, drive them to the website. Craigslist then changed their format, and you couldn't put live links in there. That changed things, but people figured ways around that. And then you kind of get the creeps or the creepers that and the scams in there. So I think Craigslist gets a little bit of a bad name. I think there's still possibilities out there. You just have to be real careful. But, you know, way back when I got my license, before the internet, or when the internet was just coming on, where did we post our listings?
Only newspapers?
That's where we posted our listings. Yeah. We used home magazines, we used newspapers, mm-hmm. we ran ads. We actually had to pay for them, which, you know, I think we're spoiled now
I
that we don't.
I used to do magazines
back
then. Yeah.
It was big in a good way, and I still think they're a good medium to send, put ads out.
So one of the things I see out there that you have marketers that will say, print is dead. It no longer applies, but that demographic is still alive.
Yeah. You know why they say that?
Why?
Because they don't sell print advertising.
There you go.
Right?
Yeah.
If they sold it, it wouldn't be dead, right?
Yeah.
And so, but there is a big demographic. So let's say what demographic would that be?
Sun City.
Yeah.
The people that... No, even, I'm 40, so even, what is it, 35 and over is still reading some type of magazine?
I'm 47 and I don't read the newspaper.
I don't have internet.
No, I'm just kidding.
I don't have Wi-Fi.
No, but there's people that, yeah, there's, I don't have Wi-Fi at home. There are people that have grown up with the newspaper. It's been a daily routine of theirs in the morning to get up, read the paper. And so it is still a great place to advertise. Mm-hmm. And it is the baby boomer, that older demographic. So if I was taking a listing and said Sun City, I would definitely consider running an ad in the paper for that.
So you won't pick up a newspaper. Will you pick up a magazine, though?
You know why I don't pick up a newspaper? It's not convenient
for me. It's not convenient for me either.
Right.
But I'll pick up a magazine, and I'll give it a quick look.
And so. You'll give it a quick look, yeah. And the other thing with the homes magazines, if people are looking at buying a home or selling a home, they're picking those up.
Mm-hmm.
So you're getting the eyes of the people that are interested.
The other one, too, is posting in Facebook Marketplace. That's been a really good one.
It's picking up, isn't it?
I think it's replaced Craigslist.
Mm-hmm.
I think it hasn't quite yet, but it will be in the next maybe 2-3 years.
Yeah, and the other thing, when you put your listing in the multiple listing service,
mm-hmm.
We as a brokerage have agreed to syndicate or send our listings out to all the major mm-hmm. platforms or the consumer sites like Zillow, Realtor.com,
so it does
Homes.com,
for you and
Trulia,
all that
stuff. So it automatically goes out there. So you're getting that exposure, but how can you maximize that exposure? You could really go in, create your account on Zillow, right, and go in and edit the photos, edit the comments, the comments on the mm-hmm. property and stuff like that, and make yours stand out different than everybody else's. Mm-hmm. Don't just rely on the syndication. Actually put some effort into it.
So the other thing, too, is if you post a video, maybe it could be a picture slideshow on YouTube, it allows you to be found. So that could be considered another method of posting on a website out there. There's also free WordPress websites. It's actually a blog. You don't have to do anything. Just sign up for it and start posting.
You know, you actually have a blog on your Simple List, too.
That's true.
And so, yeah. I mean, that's another thing. Each blog creates a landing page that you can send people to as well.
So the more websites out there you have, the more likely that you'll be found.
And then use keywords and make sure you're using the address of the property and that in there. So.
Okay.
What's another one?
All right, so obtain professional memberships. What do you think of that one?
So, like your chamber and membership, stuff like that?
I think so, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, so I mean, you already, right away, we all have one membership in common. We're members of the local board, right? Mm-hmm. And I think that's a good thing for building relationships with agents to help you get offers accepted, maybe get... make smoother transactions and stuff so you meet the people on the other side, mm-hmm. right? And I think it's good to give back to that local board. But you're not going to find a ton of business in there, so I think you need to step outside to your chambers and other memberships. It could be hiking clubs, it could be all kinds of stuff,
mm-hmm.
but there's where you can build some rapport with people and actually generate some business.
Well, I've seen it work for many of our agents, so
yeah.
I totally... encourage everyone to start networking out there.
Yeah, Ellie Morris is a master at it.
Oh yeah, he's great.
And there's more too, but I just see, I see him on Facebook. It seems to be in an event or a gathering almost every single night.
He has a great life.
Yeah.
Yeah. Party more than me.
Depends if you enjoy that stuff or not.
Yeah, that's right.
So
that's it. That's the bullet points for 2020. Top real estate marketing ideas to grow your business.
There you go. You heard it here first. Right.
Yeah.
Also, I want to send a congratulations to Tamara Coulter. She was awarded our Spirit of Signature for the month of January 2020.
That's cool.
And in the sales meeting, and she was nominated by you guys and voted in by the Associate Council. Just know that every month we're going to do a Spirit of Signature, and the nomination forms are on the front desks mm-hmm. of each office, and there's a nomination box, so make sure that you're filling those out and nominating your fellow agents so that we can get a good selection and keep that award moving. I think that's a good thing.
I nominate Beta.
Beta? Why?
He has great hair.
He has great hair. So you're the one that nominated him last month because he was good looking.
Yeah. You saw that?
Oh, we saw them all.
Oh, yeah.
You almost won, buddy.
You almost won, dude.
So, anyways, anything else?
No, that's it.
It was great. It's been a great week. I'm looking forward to next week. And that's a wrap on episode 25. And if we don't see you before Tuesday, we'll see you then.